You are looking at the most important man in the world. In America, he is called John Doe. Other countries have other names for him. He is the man without a face. Every man. The average citizen. The man who totals a billion when added to all his counterparts all over the world. In the final analysis, he will decide the future of the world. Because his importance is clearly recognized by forces that seek world domination, his mind has become a target. This is a nation seeking its own independent path to progress, but stalled in its forward march by a subversive force that grows more malignant with each passing day. In actuality, Hostland, in which outside alien hands have planted the seeds of subversion. As with most countries that find themselves in the midst of a communist-inspired insurgency, Hostland has a population with a doubtful sense of national unity. Hostland does have problems, economic, social, and emotional, and subversive insurgents are always aware of them, always ready to promise instant solutions for the price of revolution. This man is the expert on the subject. He was designated the Psychological Operations Staff Officer Advisor. Soon, with the other officers on the advisory team, he will be flying to Hostland. In the area of psychological operations, PSYOP, he is building on that knowledge, supplementing it with specifics concerning Hostland, its geography, its economy, its governmental structure. Above all, he is concerned with its people, their way of life, their religion, their culture, their sense of national identity, or lack of it. He must know the people of Hostland, for their minds will be his primary objective. With his counterpart, he reviews all available sources of information that will help him determine the attitudes of the population. How do they feel about their country, their government, and how do these feelings vary from locale to locale? Initial analysis indicates that the target audiences can be broken down into three basic groups: the subversives, the government supporters, and then the big group in the middle, the uncommitted civilians. Any PSYOP effort will have to encompass all three groups. Having mentally worked out, altered, rejected, and then finally accepted plans for the military psychological operations program, they now prepare to put them on paper as a formal proposal. They list the major psychological objectives, then the various functional group target audiences, the objectives for each of these functional groups, the severity and stage of subversive insurgency in which the various target groups find themselves, the proposed psychological military activities that should be instituted, and the proposed program to help these activities. After securing recommendations and the necessary approvals from his own people, the plan is checked with the government of Hostland. Approved by them, it now becomes the psychological operations doctrine for the Hostland military forces. A comprehensive accumulation of data is reviewed, but it is not seen as unalterable fact. It is rather a guideline for further research. And all such further research is done firsthand. They literally tour the country, sounding out the people and their leaders, seeking face-to-face meetings that will pinpoint national and local problems, what they are and where they are. In the cities, they attend labor meetings. Through interaction with such groups, their understanding of local issues is enhanced. They meet with labor leaders and industrialists. Their main goal is to find out the feeling of labor and industry toward the military and government of Hostland. In many cases, the feeling of the people toward the military establishment is similar to that shown toward the existing government. Psychologically, the military in every country in the world represents government authority. To establish the target audiences for any military psychological operations, all functional groups must be checked and their reaction to the military establishment determined. Teachers, writers and publishers, farmers, and religious leaders. Each will have a perspective that is peculiar to his own particular group. Problems, real or imagined, will come to the fore. This face-to-face, eye-to-eye confrontation with the population provides the PSYOP officer with a tool that is essential to his job. Insight, a look into the minds of a people, a working knowledge of their individual and group needs, attitudes, and ambitions. Throughout these efforts, the PSYOP program keeps the people informed. They are told what is being done. They are told why it is being done. And they are told how it will benefit them. Among the support elements needed are the light mobile printing team with its printing and editorial shelters. Also needed is a radio team to support existing radio stations, particularly in the backcountry. An audiovisual vehicle will help to increase the effectiveness of face-to-face communications. Touring groups of performers are used to attract attention. They are particularly effective in remote areas. Entertainment or diversion of any kind is eagerly awaited. Controlled interaction can result in group belonging. A continuing effort is made to link the PSYOP program with progress to help the people help themselves. This makes them see the military and the government as positive images, benevolent symbols, signifying steps toward a better life. One of the initial steps of the military PSYOP program is directed toward the Hostland military establishment itself. Since the military represents the government to the populace, their actions and attitudes can do much to create a favorable image of that government in the minds of the people. Hostland soldiers are provided with rules of conduct toward civilians and impressed with the importance of observing them. A soldier's attitude goes a long way toward implementing an effective military PSYOP program. In the more urban areas, where there is less dissension, subversives achieve only minor disturbances at best. But real grievances must not be ignored. In the rural areas of Hostland, the subversive makes stronger headway. Here he is free to promote his objectives. Here he can recruit and frequently obtain the direct support of the civilian population. The potential recruit is carefully selected. Perhaps some injustice, real or imagined, drives him where he reluctantly goes, to the side of the subversives. In some areas of Hostland, the subversives have so deceived the populace that they have very strong civilian backing. Here they are openly combating government troops. In areas where the insurgent is openly recruiting and receiving aid from the people, an internal security program takes the greatest PSYOP effort. Here the objectives are to sever the link between the insurgent and the civilian population, to detect and neutralize subversive apparatus, and to provide a secure environment. An effective internal security program encompasses roadblocks, curfews, critical supplies such as medicine, money, food, explosives, arms, etc., all of which make the PSYOP effort a little more difficult. Where restrictions are imposed, the people should be made to realize the necessity for them. Many problems are encountered during the implementation of this type of program. Curfews can alienate shopkeepers and theater and restaurant owners unless implementation of such measures is planned and announced well in advance. Curfews may also alienate the younger people who use the the evening for youth activities. Controls restrict the flow of essential products and goods. Psychologically, the people must be convinced that if it were not for the insurgents, these restrictions would not be necessary. In areas of the country where government troops are battling the subversives, the psychological effort is of a different nature. Here, in addition to directing the psychological effort at the civilians, it now must be addressed to friendly and enemy troops as well.
Every car searched.
The PSYOP effort directed at the guerrilla has one objective: to demoralize him and to motivate him to defect. By leaflet, by loudspeaker, by radio, by whatever means possible, PSYOP reaches his ears and eyes, stressing the futility of his present, offering hope for his future if he defects. With the PSYOP program underway, it becomes necessary to evaluate its effectiveness. Improvements and changes must be continually made based on the evaluations of current intelligence. Prisoners are interrogated with special questionnaires that give clues toward their reaction to the psychological effort directed toward them. Regular tours of the country afford PSYOP officers a means of direct evaluation. Interception and analysis of enemy messages and radio and TV broadcasts provides another useful measure of the effectiveness of the PSYOP program. Feedback information from the field is used as a basis for continual changes. For the psychological program must be constantly updated. As the people are affected by the program, so the program is affected by their changes in attitudes. A successful PSYOP program will make them perceive things from the desired viewpoint. When John Doe pledges his allegiance, when he decides in which direction he should project his loyalty, the issue in Hostland and many real countries in the world today will have been largely resolved. Inevitably, the moment of decision will come. And in such moments, what thoughts will pass through his mind? What images will he see? What factors will push him in one direction or another? What decision has he made? Who can say with certainty? But given an effective, comprehensive psychological operations campaign as part of the background, we could logically make an optimistic forecast.